Like, I don't want to see that type of music, really, but, like, we can tell over the past, like, 2-3 years, XX, and then it was like Lil Peep, and they're all just like.
Well, that's not well, another thing first, too.
Yeah, Peep, and then X, but like, you know what I mean? It's just like you're young, you're getting somewhere.
But sometimes
someone doesn't want to see you win.
Sometimes when you're young and you're getting somewhere, you got to sometimes hone yourself and back down and just. You know what I mean? Get out of the way of that smoke and let it boil and go, you know what I mean?
It's pretty much watching how you move. You can't do really much else but watch how you move. There's no really good way of avoiding that shit. Cause you never know who is next to you just plotting on you, you know what I'm saying? You're sitting next to me right now, but you could be thinking about what the fuck you could do to make me look bad in order to make yourself look good. You know what I'm saying? I could have invited some artist to my show that I'm trying to show love to and give a platform so that he can perform. But he may, you know, the only thing on his mind is getting fans from me just to make sure he can get ahead, or trying to embarrass me somehow, you know what I'm saying, or diss me in the future. You never know what a nigga got in his mind. Or you might just bring somebody, you know, along with you because you want to help them out. But instead of them seeing that you're trying to help them, they just see the jealousy that they have towards everything that you have. They want everything that you got without working for it. Because they don't think that you're working for it. They just think you just got it.
They want to let you do all the work and they just want all the success.
Exactly.
But honestly, one thing about this game, if you don't get no work, you don't have no success. Ain't nobody gonna just put you on. Because the world's gotta come from you anyways.
Exactly. And the thing about it is most people think that like talented people have it easy. Like you can just have a talent and everybody's just gonna wanna fuck with you. Well, it may be that way for some people, but 90% of people with talent don't get any help at all. Especially not from their close ones, because they don't think they can make it because they haven't made it. It's weird.
That's literally what I was just saying, baby. You're 1,000% right about that one.
It's fucked up because people are afraid for you because they're afraid for themselves. And it's something that you have to get past when you're an artist. Because everybody's going to have that doubt. Because they have the doubt in themselves. Like, okay, I can't do it. And then they see you next to them. And you're talking about you can do it. So in their mind, they're like, bro, you're next to me. You are exactly the same as me. Like, you have nothing different than me. You don't have anything more or less than me. How do you think you can make it, but I can't? So you know what? I'm going to just let you know and be truthful to you right now. You can't make it. And to them, they think that they're being honest and good to you by letting you know that you can't make it. But they're not really doing you any good. You feel me? Instead of saying, okay, if he can make it, well, I can make it too. Well, let's work together. Maybe we can both make it at the same time. But people don't think that way.
He was so young. That's what kills you the most. He was literally the same age. He didn't even... Well, he got a chance to live, but he didn't get a chance to do it all, like, what he deserved. Yeah, that's
crazy. It's crazy, it was so young.
Right?
It was wild seeing the when they post the birth year and the death date?
Yeah.
It was crazy seeing that. It was like, yeah, he was born after me.
Yeah, it was crazy. So what do y'all think about the COVID mind clip?
Yeah. That's
a
conspiracy, bro.
You think so?
Honestly, okay, let's not jump into conspiracies. Let's just talk about how we feel.
I don't want to say conspiracies because the child was on that, so I don't call it conspiracy, right? If it was him by himself,
that's me.
Nah, if somebody want to kill you, they don't respect you or your child.
It doesn't matter.
That's not what I'm talking about. Let's just not get into conspiracies. This is not that type of
podcast. I just think it's crazy because everyone's focusing on, okay, yes, we get it, Kobe Bryant and Gigi. You know what I mean? They were the face of, I guess, the NBA.
And she was the face of her class.
But then it's just like, what about the other people?
What about her best friend and their
friend? Yeah, that's another
thing. Like, it wasn't just them, and I think a lot of people don't see that, and they just see, oh, they're famous, so it's them. Like,
yeah, it was a coach. It was a couple more coaches, assistant coaches.
Exactly.
It was about 9 people on the board.
There's 9 people.
It's just the way they try to tarnish that man's name.
Like, I understand.
That was my favorite basketball player. I understand that's my favorite basketball player, but it was other people on there. Kobe died. I want them to say Kobe and everybody else died. It was a plane crash. 9 people died, not just Kobe, you know what I mean? And that's my favorite basketball player.
And it sucks because
that Gail Kim bitch pissed me off. Because, like, I understand what she's saying, right? The question that she's asking, she's not saying that this is happening. She's asking if it would tarnish his name that he had them allegations. Well, bitch, those are just allegations. So why would an allegation tarnish anybody's name? You can go and tell somebody that I'm gay right now, but bitch, I'm married. I'm completely heterosexual. I have nothing against gay people.
That'd be just an allegation.
But it would be an allegation. It wouldn't be nothing true. So if the court system was able to let it go and say that, no, he didn't do this shit, or I don't even know what the case came down to being there.
It was dismissed, right? So what the fuck is the fucking problem, bro? There's no fucking problem. It's a bitch that said that the nigga did something.
We know a lot of females that have been victims for real. But we also know a whole lot of bitches that have lied on niggas' names. And apparently the court system thought that that bitch was lying. So if the court system think that bitch will lie, I think we should respect it.
I feel like it's society is only a charge
The fact that you got charged with it.
The court of public opinion is different from the regular.
I don't care what you get charged with. You feel me? If the court system say that you're not guilty, I got to respect that. There ain't nothing I can do about it.
I know Kobe will do it.
If a judge
ain't doing it, he ain't got an iPhone, he ain't doing it.
Even though you don't know,
I know he didn't do it. That's the part that I'm saying, the conspiracy part.
They trying to take Kobe out of the game by doing that. We all knew it wasn't real.
Well, let's not get into conspiracies.
It's like, but I'm saying, like, the reason why it's like, the take.
You're back on conspiracies.
They keep going after him, though. Like, they keep going after the same dude. And then when you, like, those same certain articles.
Well, now I don't get why people always go after someone that can't do anything about it. They're no longer here. Why are you talking about it?
Why didn't you say any of this while they were here? Like, even with the Vic Mensa shit, whenever he said that shit about XXXTentacion after he died, like, okay, I understand your point of view. And I agree with your point of view, you should never lay hands on a woman. You feel me? And honestly, people are going to hate me for this, but I feel like men should be able to defend themselves from women, too.
And see, I don't lay my hands on a woman.
If a woman hit you, I think you should be able to hit her back. I'm not saying beat the bitch ass. I'm just saying, if the bitch hitting you with enough force that you feel like you being hurt, my nigga, just, hey, you feel me? Knock the bitch out real quick.
And I respect that 100%. I'm not gonna lie. You know a lot of people.
Like, even punching me in the arm, that shit pisses me off.
But you need to know that a lot of females have, like, nigga strength.
So, oh, yeah,
I know.
When a bitch will hit you like a nigga, that's when things happen. I've had
my lip busted by a female before, so I don't put nothing past no female. We in 2020. Females are completely equal.
She looking like I done busted a nigga already.
Listen. Yeah, she knows she done punched a nigga before.
She was probably surprised that the nigga punched him back. He put his hands on you first, and on him on his ass.
Beat that nigga down. Grab whatever you can and beat that nigga ass. Oh shit! Get on the camera. the Lord.
No, no.
My dog said, no, but, came yeah, through our podcast, you know what I'm saying? Came a little late, but still came through.
I'm 6 foot, but I'm only
5'11". Okay, you're only
5'11". Does my I'm not gonna be blatantly disrespected, and you think I'm just gonna be some little ass princess not gonna do anything about it.
Listen. All I have to say about that, look.
Because you're pretty small.
I'm not finna tell you what to do. You can do whatever you want. If you want to punch 10 niggas, you can go ahead and do that. I'ma just let you know. You better be prepared to get punched back by at least one of them niggas. Because, like, there's a lot of niggas that will literally take an ass whooping from a female and run away from it, and the bitch will keep on hitting, keep on throwing shit, and the nigga just, I done seen niggas get stabbed and still don't do shit to the female. Like, nah, bruh. Listen,
that's always
listen,
listen.
If I feel like my life or my health
is in danger, it's like the eye is a turning point.
And what I mean by health is, well, you my blood is coming up out my body.
It's like if your mind
being healthy means your whole blood is in your body, right? Once the blood start leaving your body, you're not healthy no more. So if you cause my blood to leave my body, that means I need to do something about it. And I'm not saying I'm gonna beat your ass, but you see, I got 8.5-inch hands. I'll knock you the fuck out with one slap.
Fuck it.
That's after you get him in the eye. That's after the eye. I'm just clarifying. He ain't with you now. Hit him in the eye.
I will say this. I have never put my hands on a female.
Okay. I got
first. First. I have defended myself, and I only hit the bitch once. You feel me? But I have never, ever, ever disrespected a female by putting my hands on her first. Never.
Real talk.
I've never had to come to that.
Real talk.
I've never had to come to that. Like, shit, even with crazy.
Well, you gotta worry about her knocking you out. But if you put your hands on.
It's not even that. Like, it's not even that, bro. Like, if you break my nose, what the fuck am I supposed to do? You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
What if you break
retreat,
my tooth?
Retreat.
You gotta
I know
that.
Skinny ass niggas that can break teeth. Yeah. I'm pretty sure you can break a tooth. You 6 foot.
I'm pretty sure.
5'11". 5'11", wow, close wow, enough. You put on heels, you taller than me. I'm pretty sure you can knock a tooth out. So, all I'm saying is, it ain't fucked up. We equal. Hey, it's 2020. I am giving you the quality that everybody wants. You know what I'm saying?
That's only fair.
She's only 5'11".
So, who's fighter as an equal 5'11 person?
I won't fight her.
She'll probably win
it. I won't fight her.
I'm not a fighter.
Don't put that in.
I don't know how to fight.
I won't fight no female. No. I will defend myself by slapping the fuck out of her once.
What if that doesn't work? What
do
you
think
against Ronda Rousey, bro?
Yeah, she
take
that one.
Wait a minute.
She like.
First things first. Listen.
They got killed.
If her thighs are bigger than my thighs, I'm not fucking with her, bro.
Hold on.
She hits you.
You know what I'm saying? Bro, listen. Listen, look. If her arm is bigger than my arm,
it is.
I'm not fucking with her, bro. And if I'm fucking with her, then I know better than, you know, to disrespect her. Like, if she can whoop my ass, then I'm not finna get into that.
So would you deal with a lot of those chicks with the steroids and the injections?
Honestly, that's a hard question to answer because I've never been put in that situation.
I feel you. Because then with the hormone imbalance, you might square up.
Listen, this is what I believe, and I believe this in any relationship, even in mine. I am married, so I believe if you are getting to a point where you want to put your hands on your significant other, you shouldn't be there.
I
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying.
You feel me? Because at that point, like, it's not love.
Not
you know what I'm saying? If I love you, I don't want to hurt you.
No, so I get caught in that bullshit where they be like, leave. So I've had it happen to me in a relationship before. I left before because she got me that angry, and I wouldn't fight her. So I was like, yo, I'm just gonna go get something to eat. You're probably hungry. And I left. But you know what I'm saying? So I went to get McDonald's.
And then he changed.
And I came back, and she was even more mad that I left. And I'm like, something could have happened to me while I was gone. It's a bullshit. I'm just like,
I mean, that's understandable, but putting your hands.
Like, I'm back with food.
With food.
Why are we?
Look, I understand that. All I'm saying is, you can fight with your significant other, you can have the hugest arguments, all that shit. But once you feel the urge to hurt them, I don't think that's love.
Yeah, I agree.
I can want to discipline my son, but I'd never want to hurt him.
Yeah.
You see the difference? Like, if you get to that point in a relationship, you should not be with you.
But it's also
and that whole leaving and coming back and leaving and coming back shit, no. Like, if it didn't work out, it's not going to work out. Like, we've seen it on everybody multiple times.
You left for a reason.
You feel me? Like,
majority of the time, that reason you won't be there when you get back.
Exactly. And honestly,
so
like I said,
you can't work it out.
If you are angry, at your significant other, you would rather punch a wall than put your hands on them, or you would rather take a walk or do anything rather than hurt them. That's when you know you love them. You know what I'm saying? Because it takes a lot to not want to hurt somebody. I want to hurt a lot of people all the time. But I got anger issues.
I have a question. So, how do y'all feel about the whole Dwayne Wade situation?
Honestly, don't say he's still a person.
No,
whatever he wants to be called, she, whatever.
I heard
the point is,
a transgender,
look,
so I don't know.
All right.
The reason why I asked that is because did you see what Boosie posted?
Yeah.
Okay,
I don't know the situation. I don't know if Dwayne Wade is allowing him to go with the transition. Or if he's just supporting the fact that he would like that son. You see what I'm saying? And it's hard as a parent to say to your 12-year-old, leave my house. You're not welcome here. Or tell him, I don't love you because you're gay. And that's the thing. If Dwayne Wade wants to call his son a sheep, that's cool. If, like, I don't agree with, you know, like the whole transition, at 12 years old, because I agree with Boosie, he doesn't know what he's doing just yet. Like, at least all the way. You never know, he might want to be a top. You know what I'm saying? He might want to still use his penis, just as a gay dude.
12-year-old,
but at 12 years old, I don't think he should be doing the transition, but still it is none of my business, so I don't hold judgment if he does or doesn't.
Well, at the end of the day, I'm pretty sure if
you're
being told that
he's
still, like, can't do it, like,
I'm pretty sure
whatever.
If your parent allows it, you can
do it. It's kind of considered more of a surgical situation. So, like, you know how, like, you can't be, in order to have a boob job, you gotta be 18 at least. You know what I mean? Those surgeries are still significant.
Your parents came
them
out?
Mm-mm. Not until you're fucking
18. 18, yes. That's what I was gonna say.
So, well, okay. Well, then I don't see a problem.
Right. Go with the support kid. Go with the surgery.
Well,
if she
wants to be called a she, then that's her business.
Correct. My thing, though,
she
is
happy,
like,
she
it's,
happy.
It's not your family. So you got to know, anyone saying anything ain't got nothing to say. It's
like I said, it wasn't
family.
My business.
Yeah.
I can speak my opinion, but I hold no judgment.
But my only opinion would be just like, yo, wait for you to be adult and finish growing and changing before you start.
Like I said, he might want to be a girl right now, but he might still want to use his penis later on.
You never know.
You
can just go broke later on and make sure they get that same experience again. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think it's reversible.
If
Bruno Mars is here.
gonna say his name every time on the hour.
Who's the African guy on the Daily Show?
Oh, you're right. Oh, you're right. What's that nigga name?
You're talking about right on the Daily Show.
Is that like Bruno Mars and then, what is that dude name from the Daily Show?
Damn it. I know him.
John Stewart?
No. The other guy.
Light skinned nigga from Africa.
Trevor Noah.
Trevor Noah. Cousins, you would be one of them. You hear me?
Yo, start doing stand up and be a, like, what's the, like a, not the body double, impersonators? No, the ones that look like, they look like impersonators.
Nah, the man's a cameraman, let him be a cameraman.
Are you getting paid? Niggas look like
the jackass. Hey, niggas get paid. Hey, cameraman get paid too.
The stunt double. I was actually offered from someone that's out in Orlando to be a Bruno Mars impersonator.
See?
And you didn't take it?
You sleep.
What? If I'm gonna sing for someone, I'd rather them know who I am instead of.
Man,
Hey, come and let people know who you are, man. Huh? Let the camera
know. Let them know. They think we're talking about Bruno Mars.
Let them know your name. What's good?
I'm a photographer.
He's a photographer. You know what I'm saying? And he can sing. So,
thank you.
You know
what I'm
saying? I'm here, cool name.
I don't know if it's Daniel Ortiz. Daniel Ortiz?
No, I actually just changed it. So it's _ split image.
Oh. Okay.
Because I
do
photography and video. So.
First thing that comes to my mind is split second from Xbox. Still changing. Split second. Ooh, that's a solid game.
And if you can't get up and do that, you can get up to free will.
That was good.
Or y'all can just ask me about it.
Or you
can
get that.
That's my
photographer.
Yes,
if you're
talking to TV nerds, we also know TV
nerds.
Hey,
listen, I actually have an announcement to make. Soon, I'm going to be having what I like to call a Kush Foggy movie night. So, what we're pretty much going to be doing is. So, listen, any movie that you could think of that will trip you the fuck out, we're going to be playing. You feel me?
It's gonna be
we're
going to
be
now.
Selecting ourselves for the first few, and then after a while, we're going to let y'all select what y'all want to watch. And we're going to be doing this once a month. Like I said, it's going to be called the Foggy Movie Night. And you pretty much get to come in, you get to watch a movie on a huge screen.
And smoke.
You get to smoke all you want.
Of course, where the ball would come from.
Exactly. We don't have smoke machines. Well, we have smoke machines, but we're not going to be using
them. We're talking about real smoke.
Real smoke, coming out to lungs.
You got to run your gas, man.
Exactly. Hey, we're going to have edibles and drinks. And for the people that don't want to smoke, you can come in and drink. And we gonna have alcohol too. You know what I'm saying? So it ain't no problem. You feel me? We got you. All you gotta do is pour the fuck up. It's a new vibe, you know what I'm saying? We got the Mystic Martian. They coming soon. You feel me? We're gonna be doing this.
Right out.
I'm finna make some snacks. Fuck
yeah, I'm a dog. They gonna be cooking. You know what I'm saying?
My thing is with him, he needs to have his own stomach snacks. So.
Blood out.
Stomach
y'all remember
snacks.
That?
Yeah, stomach brands.
I don't know why you haven't started that.
Yeah.
I don't know why you ain't even started
stomach
that.
Stomach snacks.
Come on, there's an art
right
stomach snacks.
You see, that's what the fuck I be talking about. It's a room full of women. You feel me? A suggestion comes up, and the nigga is not like, I don't know about that. Oh, maybe this would be a problem. Nah. Nigga jump right on it, yeah. We can do that, yeah. Nah, lazy ass niggas, bro.
It's a Well, they got ideas and new
lazy
saying.
Lazy ass niggas, you bring know what them you in say, idea, got idea. First thing that come out their mouth. First thing that come out their mouth is a motherfucking excuse on why they can't do it. They can't never think of the reasons why they should do it. They always think about why they can't. I got
you.
But it's gonna take so long. But in order to do that, we gotta do this. Mm-hmm. Instead of thinking, okay, we gotta do this and that, and it'll be done. Right. That quick. Is that easy?
Yeah. I always say, just be like Nike and just do it.
Yes.
Hey, but stop putting people's name out there. You might get sued. They not sponsored.
Yeah, but just say be like and just say just do it.
Look,
matter of fact, be like Creep. Be like Creep and just do it.
Somebody take my life.
Oh, yeah. You know that what?
Oh, so what, you think of my life.
The clearance is you can't put their brand in front of it, but as far as saying about it, so we can't do this.
Oh. Oh, well, don't do that.
There's no camera on me.
Oh, well.
That's why I didn't show you.
Well, thank you for letting me know that.
Say that.
We'll cut that out later.
Just
Google
it how it's fucked.
So look, that's that. And then I'm having also an open audience podcast. And the guest is to be announced. The date is March 5th. And I'm going to be charging people, you know, $10 a pop to get in and watch the podcast with whatever guest I have for that evening. And I'm probably going to do that shit once a month or two. I'm going to have, you know, someone interesting. I'm not just going to have some average Joe. But I'm going to have something going every month. You know what I'm saying? So y'all just keep up with that shit. That shit will be big. And we got new merchandise by Creep Red. You feel me? As you can see, the shirt came.
Clean. Yeah,
you feel me?
Let's say clean.
We got all colors. Any color you need. Creep Red clothing.com.
Red. We got female clothing too. And my dog Creep is the one designing the outfits for the ladies that won
the
competition. So they're going to be in the next fashion show representing Creepwear. And they're going to be having their photo shoot taken with Creepwear clothing.
So they're going to be looking extra spicy. So y'all going to be wanting to look at them photos. So. I'm talking about to the crowd right now. I'm talking to the crowd. They gonna see them. Not y'all. Y'all won't be in them. I'm talking about the crowd. Y'all don't want to see them photos.
So, we're going to get to this interview segment of the podcast. I'm going to be interviewing the beautiful singer, Tay.
Glad.
So, I should start with first. You know what I'm saying?
Let's ask who want to go first.
Who want to go first? So, Tay, how long have you been single?
I think it's funny. Everyone always asks that question when it comes to me. My whole life,
kind of. Ever since you.
Now, I'm just gonna ask you what the people are probably thinking. So, you know what I'm saying? You say your whole life, you know, people looking at you like she looked pretty young. So, they'll want to know what kind of number you put what you like, how serious you got. I ain't saying like since you were small, saying it's my serious, putting
like in serious
mode.
Like when you started pursuing.
Yeah, pursuing. Not saying when you started saying it or whatever. I'm talking about when you started going hard at it, saying, okay, this is what I want
to
do.
When you knew that's what you wanted to do.
Well, I want to bring it back to, I was 6, maybe 5 and a half.
Dope. I can relate to that because I was young whenever I knew it. Like, I would gather the whole, like, my whole neighborhood all outside. You feel me? This was in Honduras. We didn't have no TV, so nobody was interested in anything else.
That's what outside activities was.
So I had everybody pile up and I would recite some song from the latest singer and some shit. I was singing back then, but you feel me, I can't sing no more. I don't smoke too many cigarettes. So kids, you should all smoke cigarettes. Y'all gonna sound like me. So like I was saying. So you say like around like 6 or 5, all right. So that was when, like around the time when you kind of like pictured yourself in front of a whole crowd.
Honestly, yeah. I had to do it everywhere I went because my mom used to be like, oh, my daughter can sing, my daughter can sing. Yeah.
It's good that she was supportive of that. I didn't have that. I didn't have that supportive shit. Yeah. I was always told, you really think you can do that? Like, nobody else in our family is a singer. Like, you really think you can do that? I'm like, yeah, I really think so. But, so your whole life you've been doing like what, like talent shows and stuff like that?
It first started off, I was 5 or like 6, and I was walking around with my mom. I was just humming a song that she used to always sing. And I was just humming it. And she like pulled me over like to a bunch of random people she didn't know. And the next thing you know, it was like a talent show. Maybe you get a class, but I never liked classes, so I never went. But like she always tried to push something. At first I didn't like, I knew I liked it, but like, I didn't know there was really anything else I wanted to be. I couldn't picture myself, obviously, that young. But.
Dope. So, 9.
Yes.
How long have you been here?
Well, see, it was off and on, but it started when I was 12. I started out writing poems. But for some reason, I was in foster care. And I was going through a lot. And for some reason, I always had a deep connection with music. So I started adding rhythm to my poems, like beats. Like I always was good with doing beats with pencils and stuff. So, like, I'm so serious. Like, and I found out about instrumentals, and I started tagging into instrumentals, and I started going from there. I also used to draw, like, when I write. It would be a video of drawings, like motion drawings. And I did that for a little bit, and then I stopped. It was, I'll show you.
You still do that with little motion drawings?
No. I draw, though. I draw. I don't know. I just don't have the equipment for it. But
what's the equipment that you need?
A lot of stuff. I need the camera and stuff, and I need like a lot of paper. I started rapping again. I did a few talent shows.
Have you not known anyone yet?
Yeah. But yeah.
What are these?
Cameras.
What'd you say you need?
Oh my God. Is he serious right now?
I'm asking you seriously. Yeah. What'd you say you need? You said you need cameras, right? Opportunities right here. That's all I'm saying. Now continue.
Okay. So, I was doing talent shows and I kept writing when I was going through some things.
That's what I'll come from.
I never really pushed
you. You gotta go through something to put some good. Soul music, after all, you gotta go through something. If you don't go through nothing, you ain't gonna do it. So you gotta go through some things. So the things that y'all going through, that might be hard, It's part of the cycle. It's definitely part of the struggle. It's part of the cycle. You got to struggle. This city's got to crawl for you, you know what I'm saying, walk. So just consider yourself crawling. Y'all gonna be walking next. You got to put that in your mind. I'm crawling now, but I'm gonna be walking soon. And walking, what I mean, is not literally walking, but you know.
But you're gonna be moving a little faster than you are.
But you got to do one step at a time, so you know. It's gonna take time.
And that's the thing. That's the thing about it. Like, people notice that they, whenever they enter a career, it doesn't matter what it is. I'm not just talking about like music. I think you get the first thing I heard. They get like a whole bunch of problems. So they say, I'm gonna put a pause on my career, I'll fix all these problems. People gotta realize, like, you gotta fix your career because your career will fix your life. You see what I'm saying? Like, once you have your career going, any problem that comes by can be fixed with the money you make off your career. But if you stop your career to fix problems all the time,
all you're doing is
pretty much
holding your career.
Prolonging the time that you're broke. You feel me? You're just making your broke time longer. When you could have been fixing your career at the same time you're fixing your problem. And honestly, most people like to sleep more than they like to be successful.
That's where I differ from a lot of people. I would rather be successful than have a good night's sleep. As a matter of fact, in the past,
shit, since January 1st, damn near every day I've been going to sleep around like 1, 2 in the morning, something like that. I have to wake up at 5 in the morning and go to work. And that's just all career moments that I'm making. Whether it's a phone call, a flyer, a song that I'm working on, a deal that I'm working out with somebody, there's always gotta be something going towards my career to make sure that I get there faster. Because I feel like the more time I spend getting to where I want to be, the less time I spend being where I don't want to be. So it's pretty much that easy. You know what I'm saying? It's hard all along the way, but it ain't as easy. But yeah. So I want to ask y'all a question real quick. What led y'all to dress as Jessica?
Came up with an idea.
Honestly, so how this went, at first we didn't have any idea what we were gonna do. So then we went to a Halloween store on 41, the one that's open all year, in the middle of the night. Like, I would say it was probably 9 o'clock. We just walked in there, and I know someone that works there, so we just went around looking at all the costumes. And then I saw we saw Lilo and Stitch, we saw everyone. Every two couple with the Joker, but they were still like, makes no sense. So, and then I was like, it's Valentine's Day, it's about love. Why don't you do something you love? I like angels, I don't know why. But then he came over and we were talking about, okay, we need a character that's love Valentine's Day. He's like, why don't you get a couple that would be in love? What are your favorite characters? And I was like, I don't know, I didn't have any. And then we just started naming them off the bat, and I'm pretty sure none. And they talked about Jessica Rabbit and Roger Rabbit.
So it was your idea.
Honestly, I didn't even know.
So hold on, she just told us secretly what the idea was. She was talking, but then she said, but.
But that's good. So that's good, though. She gave the credit to who it was due.
Yeah, we know who it was.
Honestly, I didn't know that Jessica Rabbit was Jessica Rabbit's name before this.
Neither. I was totally lost. All I knew was the lady in red.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
the lady that Roger Rabbit liked it.
You feel me? Like, Roger Rabbit was smashing them a fine-ass bitch in the cartoons. You know what I'm saying? That's all I knew.
Didn't see her face, but...
I ain't knew what the fuck my name was.
Oh, my God.
He just had him a bad bitch. That's what I knew about a bad bitch. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, my God. It's just
they
like...
Warned us. It's a good pick.
It's just like, I don't know. I like Jessica Rabbit, Roger Rabbit, because I'm goofy. Like, if you ever be around me sometimes,
oh, my goodness.
I just,
so it was your idea you wanted to be Roger Rabbit?
Yeah, and I just felt like it fit her so much because she can sing. Like, I was like,
and she did sing the Jessica Rabbit song.
Yeah, and I'm just, and she learned it with that.
Damn, how many times did you listen to it in that day?
By learning the whole song or getting the tune right?
Exactly.
Either one.
It took me about 4 hours to get the words down, and it took me maybe 30 minutes to get the tune down.
You see, that's talent right there. I can't do that shit. I can harmonize with somebody.
Yeah, I can't copy words. I have a hard time copying my own words. I gotta look at it again, like, what I said?
I had chorus when I was
I'd be like, oh, I did say that. They're like, that was bad.
I had chorus when I was legit, so I can harmonize. Like, if someone's singing, I can harmonize with them and not sound bad. But if I'm by myself...
Listen, the music turned up, don't nobody sound bad.
Exactly.
True. No, but like I said, I can harmonize with somebody. I can carry a tune. That's not a problem. Like, if I were to do, like, a feature with a female, I can, or even with another dude that can sing, I can hold a note singing along with somebody and not sound bad or make somebody sound bad. But by myself, I don't think my voice sounds good enough to try to sing.
So what
are
you? Maybe in the future you'll try some, right? okay.
Maybe if I get some classes on how to use my voice now. Because I'm pretty sure I can do some type of singing. I just don't know how to use my voice. Because the way I was taught as a tenor, a higher pitched voice than what I have now. Now I'm a baritone. I'm a bass.
I'm a soprano.
Right.
My range is...
Oh, so you switch
so
it up.
So you soprano?
I can sing opera. That's why I perform things for harmonics.
What are you?
But I can also...
She wants to just bypass where she just said. Elaborate.
I don't know. I would say alto. I sing crazy.
See, that's what I have to do.
Yeah, and see, I was riding the alto. I was a tenor when I was
in
the
alto.
I got taught how to use higher notes. I was never taught how to sing like a baritone, like how to use my bass voice for singing. So I feel like if I were to get a teacher to teach me how to use my voice, I would be able to sing on a song, just not the way that I would sing.
That's how I do a lot of songs. Mm-hmm. If you listen to a lot of songs that I sing, every single one of them is always like in a key lower.
Lies.
No, I'm not joking.
Lies.
That's not a lie.
Lies.
Okay. All the songs are in lower keys because I don't try to match their note. And it's not, I'm not comfortable singing it in that key.
Yeah, that's something that I had to learn too. Like, not trying to match someone's voice. Like, a lot of people do this whenever they sing along to a song, they'll try to match the voice. Like,
sing but that's, like that's the not person. Good. Yeah, that's not good.
You're supposed to hit the note with your own voice.
It's made for two different
same
notes.
Note, your own voice. Because when you try to hit the same voice as someone else, that's when you might hit a different key and you sound stupid. So, I heard Tang got a single.
Oh.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'll
put you on the spot.
Let them know. What the fuck is the point of an interview?
I'm working on a few songs. Because everyone asked me after my first performance, where's my music, and I don't have any out.
So listen, if y'all want to hear, because we've been talking a lot about her singing, if y'all want to hear her sing, just go to my Instagram. And one of the videos. When do you plan on putting some out?
This seems possible. I got a lot of stuff that I haven't even wrapped yet. Like I said, I didn't get a chance to record like that. So, yeah, I'm working on a few things.
Well, look, this is your opportunity right now. This is a great launch for a career because, first of all, you're getting your own footage. You got this interview that's going to shout out your music. And you're going to be in a fashion show. You're already doing shows. You don't even have nothing recorded yet. There's people that have been recording for years. You feel me? I'm just trying to let you know how far ahead you are. You know, you're doing great. You're already doing shows. You're, from what I've seen in the past 3 weeks when you've been doing a show a week, so you're ahead of most people. Most people are home every day of the week, but they call themselves a rapper.
Not putting in work. They rapping at home.
They ain't doing
that's
shit.
They putting in work.
Literally a rapper they're on home, Instagram, putting in work. Facebook, but they ain't doing shit. You out here doing it. Like I said, you gave me your own photos. So you got professional photos that are gonna be up on your page. Then, once you drop your music and people have seen this interview, they're gonna go look for your shit. So, let them know what the fuck your Instagram is.
Okay, my Instagram is Naya Namaste. N-I-Y-A-Namaste.
My bad, repeat that again, because they might have not heard you, because my dumb ass interrupted you.
Please, stay tuned, because I will be dropping some fire shit. I know old shit, some new shit, clear shit. Naya dot namaste, don't forget it.
Whoop.
Yes, sir.
Hey, let them know where to follow you at.
Mine's way more difficult.
It's some shit like in French or some shit.
It's not in French, but French in it. It's Lovely Desire in Portuguese.
Oh, in Portuguese. I was wondering because like it was like close to Spanish or something.
Yeah, it's Desejo Adorado. You can spell it.
Drink this.
Tomato
Supreme.
She already sang.
Actually, in my new single that's coming out on my birthday here.
When is your birthday?
My birthday is going to be April 6th. It's going to be a Monday.
What?
So
April?
You guys should come by because it's going to be cold.
Oh, it's going to be an open mind.
I know. I'm doing it all.
That's what's so nice.
Yeah, so you'll hear some high notes.
Tay wanted to act like she was just going to bypass the Philharmonic shit. She was like, yeah, Philharmonic. Nah. For those of you who don't know what the Philharmonic is, there is one in various cities in the country, and it's a long chain of very I got a speech impediment. Fuck you, don't judge me. Like I was saying.
Very prestige.
Line of, opera Like, it's a lot of people singing. Hey, what do you call it? A choir. There you go. See, she knows more than you. She knows more than you. She knows more than you. No, shut
up.
No, but the opera is the one that that's an opera singer. Okay, so you are not an opera singer. You're part of a choir. That's what I was trying to say. So see, she knows. And you're not even right. That's the worst problem. I would have decided he was right, but you're not even right. Like I was saying, she was part of the choir. That was my dream when I was in school. I wanted to be part of the film. But I was not that good at singing. You know what I'm saying? I had dreams of being that good at singing. My teacher said she could make me that good at singing. Talking about something, if you pay for these classes, listen, show me videos of all these niggas that can sing really well. Man, that be you. Okay, right. Yeah, let's do it. But yeah, yo, how'd you get to that though? She got you like an audition or some shit?
It was more of, I lived in Jacksonville for a while first, and I went to the charter school for music. I lived there for a little bit, and then I moved to Naples, and we looked for a charter school, and I was
session. Shout out to Creepwear. Yo, y'all go listen to my music on Spotify, you know, at Team Chris Riley. You feel me? That's the name of the fucking EP. So you feel me? That shit is fucking quiet.
And make sure y'all follow the FC. We want to be doing some good things.
Hey, man, y'all like and subscribe, man. Y'all like doing shit, y'all like what the fuck I'm talking about, the advice that I give, you feel me?
Subscribe.
Share that shit. Stop being stingy and lazy. It take like 5 seconds. You feel me?
Take a whole minute. Subscribe to TV Nerds too.
Take a whole minute, but still, it's a minute. You know what I'm saying? What the fuck is a minute? We just took a minute just to try to log out of this. But look. This has been a smoke session. We had Nine Namaste and Tate in the building, my dog Creep.
Woo-woo.
Thank you, Gabe. Thank you, Icy.
Right out.
Y'all didn't see him, but I have my dog Fajito in this bitch. Shout out Fajito.
In the back,
you know what I'm saying? And I am Romeo Kush. Y'all can follow me on Instagram at I am Romeo Kush. And guess what, bitches? I am up next.